Hello everybody, this is Lobo Rican Q from PlaySomeVideoGames.com. Forgive my voice. I attended a football game last Saturday. My alma mater went on the road and we got beat against one of our rivals. And I lost my voice in the process, so please forgive me. I'm trying to get my voice back as soon as possible. Thank you for watching this video. I've been a little bit absent from just the PSVG community. I've been just a little bit busy with grad school, but my goal is to continue delivering you all, you know, good gaming videos and some solid content. So today we're gonna play ReCore. It is midnight. It is the evening between Tuesday and Wednesday. This game came out, I guess you could say, 24 hours ago, midnight of, you know, Monday. But yeah, so my goal is to just get you guys some solid content and I guess along the way give you some commentary on what the game feels like and what the game just I'm really excited for this game. I was really looking forward to it after E3, and you know, even from the original trailer that we got, I think a couple E3s ago. I know Coach Mo also got it, so I look forward to talking to him and seeing what his feelings about the game are. To be completely honest, I haven't read any reviews. I haven't looked at any scores. I've completely avoided the gaming review machine today. I did not want to ruin the game for me. I just want to go into it as pure as I can and just let the game give me what it has to offer. So on that note, we will get started. Like I said, this is the very first time I launched this game, so let's see what we got. I like subtitles, HUD scale. I have no idea what the difference is. I normally like to stick to the settings. I'm just gonna go with it, and if I need to make changes along the way, I will. Okay, great. Here we go. I always get excited when I play new IPs. You know, it's like, oh man, it's like this is a brand new IP, a brand new world, a brand new gaming universe. You never know. I mean, you don't know what the story has, right? I guess compared to a franchise that I've been playing for over a decade, like Halo. I don't know what Halo 6 is going to bring. I have an idea, though. You know, I have a pretty good idea of what the game has to offer. But a game like ReCore, like, I honestly have no clue. I have no clue what's going to happen. I'll tell you one thing that I'm not liking right now. These loading screens are killer, man. All right, seems like we're about to launch. Maybe. Here we go.
Far Eden. It wasn't supposed to be like this.
Go on, Mac. It's over there.
But if anyone can set things right, Jewel, I knew it would be you.
Okay. We're looking for a power source. It's the only way we're going to get our crawler back online. Do you have the scent, Mac?
Huh. All right.
Let's track it down.
So far, I may have made the game a little bit too bright. I mean, obviously, it's a desert and it's sunny, so it's supposed to be bright. HUD, okay. Movement is pretty standard. We have a double jump. Too easy. Oh, okay. Okay, aiming. I don't know if I was supposed to figure that out yet. But, alright, let's follow Mac. I like the double jump, though. Look at that world. It's so beautiful. I mean, it's desert, but, you know. Halo gave me a strong sense of appreciation for skylines, right? For skyboxes. And Destiny. Destiny does a really good job with skyboxes too. Did I see like a climbing function happening? Okay, I have to go up there, I know that. But is Mac following me? Yeah, he is. Ooh, so she does climb. So far, movement is pretty good. I mean, I don't feel... Obviously, there's an extreme to how far I can go, but... I don't feel... Like, I like movement so far. It feels good. Someone's missing their car engine. Press A. Yep.
Yep.
Got it.
My exoframe is working fine. Thrusters are recharging just like they should.
Exoframe. Alright. When I jump into a game like this and I don't do any exploration, I feel like I'm gonna miss some kind of collectible or some kind of achievement that isn't obvious to me right now, you know? Tracked a strange energy signal to a source. Whoa, what the crap? Can I shoot it? If I can. Doesn't seem like I can yet.
There. An opening at the top of the cliff. That's our way in.
But what about these guys? How far can I go? Oh wow, can I go? Oh wow. This is pretty far off track. I was expecting the game to pull me back at some point, but so far it's letting me go. It's probably not gonna let me do this though. Oh shoot, it did. All right. This is a big sandbox then. Anyone else getting like a Halo vibe here? Am I the only one getting that vibe? Like a Halo ring kind of vibe? You know, when you drop on the ring and you're like, okay, I guess I have to go to the waypoint, but I could also just, you know, spin around the Warhog for like 20 minutes.
Looks like the scavenger bots have picked them clean.
Scavenger bots. Because there's definitely a difference between Halo 1 and Halo and the rest of the Halos, to be honest. I mean, in many ways, Halo 3 ODST, the side game, the side branch game, in many ways, ODST was more faithful to the Halo 1 game style. Right, like Halo ODST let you do all that exploration, and it let you like just walk around the city at your own pleasure. So in many ways, like I'm, you know, the fact that I have a waypoint, but I can like, you know, just run whatever I want. It's kind of cool. Now I'm gonna go up to that floating thing. I think those are the scavenger bots that she was talking about. I want to see how I react to them. Or how they react to me.
Scavenger core bites. Hey! Why are you attacking us?
Yeah. Why are you attacking us, punk? So I killed all of those dudes. There was an auto aim. I'm not sure if I'm a fan of it or not. Obviously my gun has a max amount of shooting before it overloads. Let's see, let's overload it and let's see how long it takes to come back. Oh! Oh, so it takes a really long time. All right. Okay, so even if I run out of ammo, it'll come by pretty quick.
Okay.
Good. I'm guessing this one's going to attack me also. Do you see how these flags have these logos? I guess Eden, New Eden, right? That's what that means.
Watch out, Mac.
Where's Mac? So there's the New Eden flags, and then you have these that say 512 pylon. Is that like a construction thing? Is that like a unit or a company? The moment I killed those guys' robots, that guy just peaced out, right? I wonder if one of my criticisms of this game will be that there's all this place to explore. And nothing to see. So he's like a flashlight. All right. All right, let's go ahead and head to the beacon. Let's see what we have to discover. Max seems ready to go. In many ways, Max is like a glorified waypoint. Like, he seems to find the routes.
Right. Let's make our way to the top. Lead the way, Mac. Right behind you.
New Eden flags. This is pretty sweet. It's a pretty great view. Let's see if we can get a cool snapshot right here. All right, let's keep going. So far movement is cool, shooting is cool. I wonder if I will dislike the fact that the auto aim is kinda doing my job.
Earth looked at images of far east,
for me,
saw nothing but rocks and sand. But some of us saw a future paradise.
Adams. I wonder if he's related to me. Nice. This double jump is pretty generous.
Whoa, careful, boy.
And then you have the clamor.
Down.
On the way down. Mm-hmm. All right, I should stop singing before I get sued. All right, 512 pylon, 512. Oh shoot!
Looks like this door is missing its power cell box. I wonder if I must be around here somewhere.
So, I guess the auto aim was useful there. I do feel like that was too easy, you know? Like, that was, okay, like, you know, alright, well, that was kind of easy.
There you are.
Hey, what's up, buddy? Are you gonna go, or am I gonna make you? Alright.
In you go.
New bestiary. So is that like a catalog of all the different creatures?
Come on, this way.
All Why can't I shoot at that?
Mac, get back here! Mac, Mac!
What the crap?
I'm coming, Mac!
Why can't I kill these things? What the hell? What did you do to my dog?
A security lattice? What's going on around here?
Oh, gotcha. Oh, nice. Okay, so the RB is a charge shot. Okay. Hold B to dash. Okay. Oh, got it. Whoa. Anyone get that Mega Man 5 just now? What? Oh. Can I do that? Okay. This is totally Mega Man Extreme. Like, that's the vibe that I just got just now. That was awesome. Mega Man Extreme vibe, Halo vibe. I mean, I'm getting every vibe in the book. If I jump down, can I get back up? Oh, okay, so I can dash and then do a double jump. Boom! Figured it out!
Mac should be on the other side of this door.
You better be. What?
Let me try that again.
Okay, so I do that to extract and then hold. Okay, gotcha.
Oh,
to revive your companion, move to the location, hold X.
I got you, buddy. Try and be more careful. We're not gonna find many friendly bots in here.
So she's aware of the bots, like.
Spider frames.
Oh my god.
You woke up a whole hive.
Holy crap, okay.
Rats.
Wait, what's going on? What the crap? Okay.
Gotta do more damage.
Gotcha. So if I weaken them, I can extract the cores from them.
Mac, get down.
Nice. Good job, Mac.
Didn't know he could do that.
Jewel can command her core boss to use powerful lethal abilities. Press Y while targeting an enemy to use max accessibility. Sweet.
Let him have it. That away, Mac. Give him a shot. Over there.
Sweet. Oh man. Whoa. Oh, snap.
Mac, see their frames, Mac. They were all corroded.
Corroded.
I don't like it either, but we need to keep going.
Corroded. I wonder if that is something that will mean...
Another missing cellbot. I wonder what scared them all out of their sockets. You can find it. Mac, dig in.
Sweet. Good job, Mac. You're awesome.
Don't worry. We won't hurt you.
Go open the door, though. Okay, so I can have auto aim. I can do the little pool extract thing. I can extract cores. I can auto aim. I can command my bots to do special attacks. I have a double jump. I have a dash. I'm trying to keep track of everything that I can do.
Must be close. Watch out, caterpillar.
What the hell? Is that it? Okay.
Corbots are much more intelligent than Corbites, but we designed them both to be absolutely loyal and highly protective of humans.
Huh. I'm getting some really weird readings from that power source. I wonder if it's affecting the other bots somehow. Come on, Mac. Power source is this way.
Cool. Oh, and I have the shard shot. Yeah, I forgot to mention that one.
My extractor should work on this door, just like before. That thing has shields. Maybe my charge shot can knock them out.
Okay, gotcha, but I'm about to die. Nice. So when they're like knocked out, like with the charge shot, I can just straight up extract them, I guess, because they're kind of like not defending themselves. That's awesome. Sweet. Okay.
Closer to it, I bet I can grab it with my extractor.
How am I supposed to do that? Am I supposed to jump down? I don't know how I feel about the voice acting right now. Like, I mean, I don't mind it, but I wonder if... Oh, boy. Come on, Jewel. Get it together, homegirl. Iron Fang. Watcher of the Granite Steps.
I'll have to do this the hard way.
Oh, boy.
We need to get that core. Let's do this, Mac.
Yeah, get some. Ooh, that to kill him? Oh boy.
Dude.
Ah.
It keeps healing itself. The only way we're gonna beat it is to pull out the core.
Come on, Mac. Get him, buddy.
Go get him.
Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. What?
It's healing itself.
No.
Pull out the core.
So I have to make him go red. What? Ah, oh, he healed himself again. Come on. Oh, I feel like I was getting. I'm about to, yeah, I know.
It's to pull out the core.
Oh, shoot. I didn't do the. Oh, my goodness.
It's healing itself. The only way we're gonna beat it is to pull out the core.
Oh, I see. I get it now. I'm actually reading the instructions. There we go. Come on. What? Are you serious?
It's healing itself. The only way we're gonna beat it is to pull out the core.
I feel like I'm doing. Ah, man.
It's healing itself.
Okay,
pull out the core.
I'm not fully grasping the instructions. Ah.
It's healing itself. The only way.
Yes. Stop. Stop saying that. It's getting kind of annoying right now. There we go. Okay. I didn't fully understand the grip thing. Like, you have to ease up on it and then kind of like let go of it. Kind of. Okay. I get it. That was a little bit more challenging than I was expecting. But
I've never seen a core like this before. Have you, Mac? All the colors are mixed together. Oh, come here, boy.
Oh, Mac. No, buddy.
Doesn't look too bad, but I won't be able to fix it here. Can you make it back to the crawler?
Okay, so I'm gonna make a couple statements. As the way that the world is built,
right,
feels like Halo Combat Evolved. You know, it feels like me walking through the ring, the Halo ring. The way I move around the map has a little bit of a Mega Man vibe, especially the dash, this dash is very Mega Man like. At first I was like, I don't know how I feel about the auto aim, but I don't mind it. I mean, it's kind of cool, because if the game was one dimensional and the auto aim did everything, then I'd be kind of bummed out. But the fact that you have to auto aim, plus you have to like pay attention to all these other elements like the enemy's health, and make sure that it matches with the little markers, and then you have to like make sure you are like paying attention to the core when you're trying to extract the core. I mean, that makes the combat pretty like pretty much more interesting. So the auto aim isn't like a bummer. But when it comes to Jewel herself, she's like a Rey from, like, The Force Awakens, you know? Like, she's like this techie scavenger, you know? Like...
Yep, there's our crawler. Home sweet home.
Oh, man, she's totally like a Rey from Force Awakens. Like... Like, they're definitely... I think they were definitely going for that. That kind of vibe. Worn pistons.
Hey, Jewel. Sorry about the other day. I've been preparing for your launch a long time. But when your ship finally left Earth, well, I haven't cried that hard since your mother died. I know I can't talk to you directly since you're already in cryosleep. And even if I could, the communication lag would just get worse the farther you got from Earth. So I thought, why not record some messages and send them to you for when you woke up? Consider them half official, half private. Well, guess your old dad can't mope around forever. We've got lots of work to do. Research to make sure the Far Eden project succeeds. I'm gonna do all I can to support you and the heroes on that ship. That includes Matt, who I hope is sleeping close beside you.
Okay. So it sounds like my dad, but you know, I'm not really sure, because why would my dad send me by myself to some far off world with crazy bots? Are these guys a little bit higher level? Oh my gosh. I'm in danger. What? Okay, so Max still alive. Sweet. There's something up there. I know I'm supposed to return to the crawler, but I can't help but do some exploring. What is this?
Hey, okay. I'm a trainer.
All right. There's so much stuff to pick up all over the place. Kind of makes me wonder if I missed something along the way. So there's the crawler right here. There's also stuff over here. I guess at some point enemies could respawn, so I don't really want to be fighting the whole time. Nice. Nice. Okay, that seems to be the top of this place. The crawler's there. Yeah, but... I wonder if there'll be more bad guys over here. I definitely like the open world element to it. I mean, it's kind of cool. Ooh, what is that? It's like raw material or something. I guess I'm not supposed to open that yet. Oh, there we go. Yep, those guys look really strong. Yep, I'm not supposed to be here. Yep, those guys, they had skulls next to them. Yeah, no. Yep, I get it. I got the message. That part of the map is a little bit too high level for me. I get it. Anything else to pick up? Okay, it looks like we got everything that is within our range. I kind of want to go up there, but I feel like we will have the chance to do that. There's a gate over there. There's that big gate over there. And then there's the path that way where those big robots showed up. The Corbites? He said Corbots and Corbites, right?
Let's get inside and see if this core will turn the power back on.
Okay, so if you hold a rifle down for too long, it becomes inaccurate. Okay, cool. Sweet. Short bursts.
Hope this works.
So has she been living, like, in the dark this whole time? Whoa, that was a minor drop in frame rate. Okay.
Weird. Doesn't look like it lost any energy at all.
Yeah, I'm not sure I like the boy's acting. I mean, I don't like being that guy who picks at the boy's acting.
Message before you go to sleep? Sweet dreams. If not, wake up already. It's been 200 years. Listen, I just wanted to tell you I've got a little more work to do here. But they're holding a space for me on the next evacuation fleet. And I'll meet you on Far Eden. Just like I promised. Don't worry, Jewel. Everything's going according to plan.
Oh, man.
I know, Mac. Nothing is going according to plan. I mean, look. The pylon in the next sector is offline. Now that we've got power, we can unlock the gate, go over there, and check it out.
Oh, wow.
This report says the pylon's been offline for... 96 years? So why didn't we wake up right when the problem started? We're the closest maintenance team, right? What happened, Dad? Where are you? And where is everybody else?
I am becoming very intrigued by this story.
Come on, Mac. We'll get you fixed up. And then we both need to fix that pylon.
Okay. So, I guess...
Come on over to the workbench, Mac.
Cool. This is the workbench. Here, Jewel can research and equip new parts, change loadouts, and upgrade her core bots. Research the blueprint and replace Mac's broken part with a new one. Okay. What are the materials? 6, 3, and 8. Do I have those materials? No. Okay, the materials are pistons, K-pads, and worn canine sensors, and 15 red fusion whatevers. Okay. Well, I guess that takes up everything that I have.
Bing.
All right, great. So I go to core bots. Select. I pick the part. Oh, wow. And I upgrade him? Oh, that is so cool. I get to upgrade like my own little fleet of robots. Oh, that is pretty awesome. Oh, I'm so excited. And his attacks went up, right? Oh, that is great. Safe loadout. That is awesome. And he got stronger. Oh, man. That is so freaking cool. You have additional blueprints in your inventory. Gather the ReCore materials and return to the workbench to research and equip these new parts. Keep your eyes open for more blueprints as you explore Far Eden. Okay?
Okay, Mac. Ready to help me fix that terraforming pylon?
Each time the crawler is entered, the cores, shards, and loot in your inventory is automatically transferred to the crawler stash. Oh, that's awesome. You can search your stash at any time by using the workbench. Okay. Sweet. So I'm going to check out the text log, the logbook. What is this? Access denied.
Security protocol V10LT? Yeah, I've never heard of it either. But we can't use the transfer plate as long as the protocol is active.
So I can energize this? Ooh. I can make him stronger. I don't know if I want to do that or not, but let's just do it. So I made his core stronger. Stash. Okay, so I have... Okay, so these parts help me build the blueprints. Great. Awesome. And the cores that I find, I can use them to not just make the parts... like the legs, but I can also use them to power up my bots. Okay, that's it. That's all I'm gonna do. I'm not gonna spend everything. I just wanted to add a little bit more. Okay. So, locate the offline terraforming pylon. Alright. Five 112 pylons, so I'm guessing that whenever I go to a new region of the map or of the game, the flags will be different. Like, it'll be like, oh, pylon 600, pylon, you know, 14, pylon 112, whatever. And each part of the world was supposed to be powered up by a specific, I guess, core or something along those lines.
The pylon is in the next sector, Mac. Let's get going.
All right. Well, on that note, we're going to wrap up this video right here. The burrito is running right around 45, 46 minutes. This has been Q from PSVG, and we have been playing ReCore. So far, I've enjoyed this game. The music is sounds good. I mean, the sound is good. The movement around the map feels good. Like I said, I've been saying that there's a vibe to Halo Combat Evolved when you're walking around the Halo ring. There's a vibe to Mega Man X when you're moving around the map and you're fighting these other robots, very Mega Man-esque. There's definitely a strong feeling of like Rey from The Force Awakens, how she's just, you know, she's this mechanic maintenance girl and she has a relationship with a robot, right? Kind of like Rey and BB-8 in The Force Awakens. Mechanics so far feel good. I guess we'll see how the story plays out. I think this game will rely a lot on its story and then seeing just how everything kind of comes together. Any cons so far? The auto aim for the enemies isn't great. I wish that it wasn't so enforced, but I can see and when you're fighting a boss and when you're fighting a lot of enemies, oh my gosh, when you're fighting a lot of enemies, that auto aim comes in handy. I don't know if there's like a setting by which you could like turn it off. That would be kind of cool, so people that don't want it don't have to use it. But otherwise, so far the game has been exciting. It's been fun. It kind of throws you in there, not knowing what's happening, and I kind of like that. I kind of like it when games just kind of throw you in there. There's a customization aspect of collecting resources and then building parts for your bots, and I really like that. I like the fact that this isn't just a campaign, one-dimensional campaign. It seems like there's more to it. And as Mac barks at me, we're gonna wrap up this video. Thank you for watching. This has been Q from PlaySim Video Games. Never stop gaming.